An historic day in federal parliament with the lower house passing the government's massive wages bailout to get the nation through the next 6 months. The legislation is likely to be rubber stamped in the Senate this evening, releasing $130 billion to prop up our spluttering economy.
Old habits are hard to shake.
Good luck. We can't do that.
We can't, exactly.
Grappling with the new rules of a dangerous age, a stripped-down parliament opened with an ancient plea.
Deliver us from evil.
Returning for just a day.
During extreme times, to consider extraordinary responses.
To confront a menace that threatens our way of life and our lives.
Today we act to protect Australia's sovereignty.
The Prime Minister evoked the echo of another war.
We will never surrender this.
As a house too often divided by petty politics, remembered why it was there.
Recognising the simple principle that looking after people is our core responsibility.
Building a safety net to catch 6 million workers comes at a great cost.
A $130 billion JobKeeper package to keep businesses in business and Australians in a job.
We are headed for a $1 trillion debt.
Labor wanted more casual workers included in the package but vowed not to obstruct it before the debate began.
Never let the perfect be the enemy of the good. And this is good legislation.
The rescue plan gives a business under stress $1,500 a fortnight for each worker it keeps on its books. To qualify, it has to have suffered a 30% loss in turnover or 50% if the business is valued over $1 billion. Charities can also apply if their losses hit 15%.
More than 730,000 businesses had registered their interest in the JobKeeper program.
Marking another dismal 2020 milestone.
We will pay the price needed to protect our sovereignty and we will chart our way out.
And we will all have to adapt. Chris Yorman, Nine News.